Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time, welcome. We got some drama for you today. In racing, the highs are high yesterday. You can see the video here. And the lows are low today. Here, I'm leaving this line for my very first run in the morning. It's early in the morning. We got our tires warmed up a little bit. The car has been faultless yesterday. I don't think I've ever driven a better handling car. And off we go. The trick here is the car had been so great yesterday. I mean, well, watch that other video. Fantastic, perfect. But this was the very first run on the notoriously bumpy top section, the summit route, the last 3 or 4 miles of the Pikes Peak Hill Climb. And I've driven it in a street car. I drove it the last 2 years. I know that it's rough, and I know it gets worse, and I know it changes. It freezes, and the heaves change, and they look bad at street speeds this year. And friends who ran yesterday told me that they were getting airborne in a couple places. So I knew. I had the warnings. And we took off from the line, and I really don't have any good excuses. Everything felt good, so I didn't go real slow. I just kind of ran a pace where I felt like I could feel it out and keep in control. I look at this video and the speeds are high. I was going for it. And a lot of that though is on a straightaway, which is kind of free. And the day before, the car had been just so sweet. And so as I enter that corner, it's called Bottomless Pit, I know there's a yump right at the turn in. I know it's bigger than it was last year. And in fact, I watch a video by a guy named Mike Skeen, who's another driver, a friend of mine who ran the Porsche Pikes Peak Trophy last year in a GT4, and he got in big trouble in that same corner, kicked sideways. So I know all that. I come into the corner, I slow it down from 112 all the way down to about 68 miles an hour, and lay it into the turn. We go through the yump, whoop, and you can hear it on the video. It goes chuff like that, and then pow, I throw a giant steering correction at the car and then recover it, because you know from skid pad training, correct, recover, right? Well, by that time, the car is going that way when it ought to be going this way, and it's just a matter of time. When we actually hit the wall, we were doing about 40, and the Tesla's giant screen actually gives you a great speed readout the whole way, so you can see exactly what the speed is doing. And what happened for me was I was completely surprised. I did not expect anything like that to happen because it hadn't yet. But you know what? It was my first run. And that is my biggest crime here at Pikes Peak, or anytime you go out in a race car. First time, first lap, you go easy enough to make sure everything feels okay. I thought I was doing that. But Pikes Peak is extreme. These heaves are enormous, and they get worse further up the mountain. So I'm not real sure what happened, frankly. I know I threw a huge correction at the car and recovered it best I could, and we ended up going off. But I know, what do you think? What does it look like to you? It'd be cool to hear your opinions in the comments below. Right now, the Unplugged Performance team is working on that Tesla to see if there's a way to bring that thing back to life, to see if we can get it fixed for the hill climb this year. So stay tuned, subscribe, hit the notification bell, see if we can make it. I'm behind those guys all the way. It's such a shame that that wonderful car got beat up like it did. Maybe we can still get it in the race. It's a long shot, but we're trying.